Somewhere where I can see you more, like on the armchair.
Oh, am I timing?
Well, do you know everything about this camera, so when Sean leaves, we're good?
Well, when I leave, you're leaving, because you're going to the yoga class.
That is true.
So
you're our man.
I'm your man.
Okay.
I am a...
Okay, what? How much time
do you And you were rolling, so let's do it.
Awesome. And we are rolling at Wanderlust Festival. I'm here with, he needs no introduction, MC Yogi. It's day three. We're all getting tired, because we've been having too much fun.
It's been amazing, man.
Largely thanks to you. So, what's going on? What's been your experience? What have you been doing?
Well, I'm like yourself, I'm a fellow traveler, pilgrim on the path here at Wanderlust, checking out all the amazing music, yoga, talking with some incredible people, and just being inspired.
What's a moment that maybe, out of all the festivals, all the traveling you do here at Wanderlust, what's a moment that stuck with you? Besides this one that's happening right now.
It's amazing, man.
Yeah.
I would say probably the most incredible moment so far was in Vermont opening for Ziggy Marley, which was like a dream come true. I was so humbled and honored to open for, you know, someone who's always been a great inspiration for me.
Yeah, that's amazing.
That's incredible.
And what was it like getting to open for him, hanging out with him and all that?
Honestly, like seeing Ziggy perform, like I just taking notes, you know, because right. I'm still a baby when it comes to performing. Like,
and he's playing tonight?
He's playing tonight. He's awesome.
Yeah.
And honestly, I could say that it's like seeing Bob Marley. It's like watching Bob Marley. Like you feel the presence of his father so strongly. It's really incredible.
Well, you, I mean, just to make up a quote on the spot, you're, I'm forgetting it. My joke's ruined. You're putting a new face on devotion in America. I just thought I'd make that quote.
Does it have glasses?
That was actually the NPR quote about what you're doing. So you're bringing this sort of yoga practice, this spiritual practice into a venue normally more associated with just kind of pure fun and emotion, you know, which is music. So how's that going for you?
It's going great, man. I mean, for me, if there's not joy in your practice, then we have to ask the essential question, why are we doing it? Mm. Because, you know, my understanding is that our practices lead us to a place of unbroken, steady joy, a consistent stream of, you know, feeling connected to the universe, like a Jedi.
Like a Jedi.
And, you know, having that joy inside of us, it helps us to deal with all these difficult situations. So even when the going gets tough, we have that reservoir of joy inside us that we can plunge back in, drink from the well, then go back out and do our work. Then when we get kind of burnt, we can go back in and replenish.
That's interesting, because one thing that irritates me a lot in a joyful way about the yoga community is that they're all about positivity.
But not force. Not,
right.
Not the costume of it.
You're saying embrace the shadow, or whatever you want to call it, the tough times, the blues of life, and you have this reservoir of joy, of inspiration, of devotion, something like that?
For me, it's an unbroken stream of inspiration. Inhale, exhale, meditation practice. As a writer, as a poet, as a designer, every time I go in, I come back feeling inspired. So for me, it's inexhaustible, you know?
Well, if there's one person other than Shiva Ray, who embodies everything that Elephant is, which is trying to offer this wonderful stuff beyond the core choir and to those who maybe didn't know they gave a care, it's MC Yogi and Shiva Ray.
Well, that's because I'm just sitting here. I'm sure you
would
say that.
Perfect.
Shiva's everywhere.
Well done, Shiva.
Shiva's everywhere.
So to wrap up, unfortunately our interviews are only 3 minutes. Our last interview was an hour and I felt like doing 3 hours. Can you do a little offering to elephant readers out there?
So we got to go like this. So I have to prove my point, right?
Hi.
Okay. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Can we do like a little yoga science?
You can do whatever you want.
Can we do some like numbers? I like numbers. Since we
Break
have Shiva here. So Shiva is the one light that shines in everything, right? In yoga philosophy. So one light, two sides, open up your third eye. Four corners of the mind, five elements combined. 6, 7, 8, 9. I think it's about time to align all 33 vertebrae of the spine. Intelligent Elephant Magazine online. Thank you so much, Waylon, for being a friend of mine.
All right.
Much love.
Hey, come here. Thanks, man. That was great.
All right.
Thanks,
all right. Thank you.
Awesome. MC.
Unbroken joy.
Was that the Masonic secret handshake? Was that-
yeah. Yeah.
Could